You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
Most writers and radio show hosts know that to connect with your fans, you need to do more than just write books or record the latest podcasts. There are many different elements that go into forming an online platform, but there are also many hidden traps. To make matters worse, solid advice on how to survive the muddy waters is scarce. In the book Hidden Traps, I talk about some of the important issues of working with an online platform, highlighting traps that could put your physical or internet security at risk, or be harmful to your reputation. Are your social media posts just links with a few disjointed words making you look like someone who can't complete a sentence? Did your new website cost you more than you anticipated? Are you leaking your personal contact details across the web without even knowing it? Then you need Hidden Traps. Hidden Traps is now available in paperback and ebook from a variety of retailers, including Amazon, Barnes & Noble, and Kobo. Visit blackwolfpublications.com for more details.
If you're 85 or younger, would you like peace of mind and comfort for your family? We're Final Expense Direct with an urgent message for you. The average funeral today costs over $8,000, but the most you'll get from government benefits is $255. How will your family pay the difference? We can help. Our senior plans start as low as just a dollar a day and pay up to $30,000 for a funeral and other final expenses. Peace of mind is easy. There's no medical exam. You'll have lifetime coverage, and your plan can't be canceled as long as you pay your premiums. Call now for free information about our senior plans. Answer a few simple questions and receive approval right on the phone. Plus, call right now, and we'll give you a discount prescription card for free. Call 800-553-8687. That's 800-553-8687. Again, 800-553-8687.
You're listening to the Spark Radio Network, internet radio like you've never heard before. Innovation, creativity, and imagination are all said to begin with a spark. So fasten your seatbelt and take the ride of your life and listen for the spark.
Game on, where progressives fear us and rhinos tremble. Welcome to the political jungle. I'm JD.
This is Stacy. No one is safe. No one is spared.
Lock up the children.
And the old folk.
Welcome to the world of libservative conservatarians.
Guadalupe, it's Jeffrey Epstein broadcasting live from New York's MCC. Good Sunday evening, August 11th, 2019. JD and Stacy here live hosting Game On that KLRN radio. Welcome back to all our political geeks, freaks, and back alley sneaks. Everybody right now, you know exactly what to do. Get over to Spreaker.com. Get over to JD and Stacy's page. Get in that chat room. Say hello to Stacy. Join the conversation. Ron, put your pants back on. We want to thank KLRN Radio and Spotify for making tonight's live broadcast a Game On possible. Tonight, we're going to be talking Do Something! Red flag laws and their constitutional limits. White supremacy is just a Stalinist tactic to shut you the hell up nonsense of the world and so much more. So top off that drink. Light up that stink. Have yourself whatever helps make you think. JD and Stacy taking you to the top of that 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Hour here live on that Game On that KLRN Radio. How's you, baby?
I'm doing fine.
Welcome to Epstein and Lennox.
Excuse you. Not even close. Not even close, son.
Too soon for Epstein didn't hang himself. He's halfway to his pedo island with Bill Joe.
But like we literally just saw a couple of tweets that are saying, despite having committed to get the autopsy results out tonight, which for a hanging should be pretty straightforward, they're not releasing them yet.
And Stacy and I, we're really not going to spend too much, if any, time on this Epstein thing. I mean, look, everybody out there, here's the problem we're having in the country, folks. We have a jam-packed show. Some of this ties into, you know, the the loss in faith in the institutions that we have tonight. We're going to get through all of it. But, you know, I think to the point that Stacey and I are making about this, I try to make it a little funny at the top about the Epstein Radio Hour. We're in a lot of trouble in this country. This guy was doing really shady, awful things with a lot of really powerful people. And the fact that whether people were waking up this morning or yesterday, whenever this happened, you know, trying to, you know, half the country thinks the Clintons had him killed. The other half of the country thinks that Donald Trump had him killed.
Which is stupid.
Listen, at the end of the day, it's bad all around. When you have that kind of monstrous loss of faith in institutions, it's really not healthy for a democracy. It's getting real nautical out there in the hinterlands. And something like this really, really doesn't help. As a matter of fact, I think tomorrow I'm going to open a tinfoil hat store. And if that goes well, I'm going to expand and start selling pitchforks and torches. And then we can be retired by November of 2020.
Awesome. I'm young enough to make retirement, fun.
Oh, okay, Kirsten Gillibrand. I'm a young mother. How old are you? 63.
She's not a young mother. She's old as dirt for her kid's age.
You didn't hear that disgrace. That was, she just stopped it in the last debate. She was running around referring to herself as a young mother because she was like the
first. You're kidding me.
I swear to you, you got to find it. She's like, as a young mother. Now, don't get me wrong. Of everybody running, Tulsi Gabbard and what's that? Gillibrand, definitely. JD, would I? Would I? Absolutely. Policies, no. But a little, hey, how you doing? Yeah. But other than that.
I was going to say, I was a young mother at 23. I think Kirsten Gillibrand had her first at 43? I don't know.
Gillibrand hasn't seen 23 since the first Clinton administration.
That's what I'm saying. The second Clinton administration, I had kids.
Do me a favor. Can you, I'm not going to say what it is. You can if you're associated with it, but could you give the audience an update on when they can expect a tyrannical social media platform to launch?
Oh, absolutely. I have had the pleasure of joining a platform called Clout Hub. That platform is actually launched in app form. Website should be here in October if you like to do it on your computer. And they don't collect your data. They won't ban you for saying a biological man cannot have his period, which Twitter probably will ban me for today. They don't like you using a lot of dirty language, but they're not going to ban your ideas.
So good stuff coming soon, kids. But now, Biggie, help us start the show off. So last weekend, everybody in the audience knows, as a country, we all woke up to the same horrific news. I believe on Sunday, there were two mass shootings last weekend, one in El Paso, one in Dayton, Ohio. Stacey and I are going to keep the rule that we have on the show. We are not going to mention either one of these absolute evil scumbags' names, but it doesn't change the fact that this has happened. And we have a sickness in our country and in our society. And we're going to help you today to break down some of what's being discussed, even by some of your favorite politicians and favorite president, and really take a non-emotional look at all of this. Because when it comes to policy, you have to. You know, JD, that's cold. I know there were 30 people killed, Bob, but if we're going to make policy, we need to do it in a non-emotive way. That's what Stacey and I are going to walk through today. But going back to the sickness that we have in this country, you had two shootings within 12 or 18 hours of each other, one done by, and I've read the manifesto. I'm not even sold that the El Paso shooter was somebody who was politically of the right, but he shot up immigrants because he didn't like immigrants. So if we have to play a jersey-wearing game, we'll call the El Paso shooter somebody of the right. And the Dayton shooter, who is an Elizabeth Warren supporter, someone of the left. So I think that augurs more than, you know, anything else, that we definitely have a societal problem in this country. And no, I don't think it's guns. I think it goes a lot deeper than that. But everybody's knee-jerk reflexive reaction when they say, do something, we got to do something, the children. And I'm a human. I have those those same exact impulses. But before Stacey and I just start the discussion, I want to give the audience an explanation of what exactly these quote-unquote red flag laws that everybody seems to be rushing to at light speed are, and how there really are some constitutional issues to it. Remember, folks, when we talk about anything in the realm of gun restriction or gun control, we're not talking about limiting or regulating a product that people buy. The Second Amendment of our Constitution, codified by the Supreme Court Heller decision in 2008, we have a constitutional right to keep and bear arms. So when you talk about red flag laws, they're also known as extreme risk protection orders, ERPOs, and they've already been passed through a number of state legislatures across the country. However, right off the bat, just the writing of, if not the implementation of these laws, causes constitutional issues. It causes Second Amendment issues. It causes Fourth Amendment issues, which is the amendment that protects against unreasonable searches and seizures. It brings up Fifth Amendment and 14th Amendment protection. What's the Fifth and 14th Amendment, JD? Those are the ones that extend due process protections. And I mentioned the 5th and the 14th because the due process clause of the 14th Amendment is exactly like the similar provision in the 5th Amendment, only the 5th Amendment restricts it strictly to federal, and the 14th Amendment brings it to the states. And then rounding out the bottom, you have 6th Amendment issues, because if any of this is seen with these reg flaws as being any kind of criminal proceeding, then you're going to get into the right of a speedy adjudication. And the 14th Amendment additionally promises that all persons in the U.S. enjoy the equal protection of laws. And this means that they cannot be discriminated against without good reason. And I want to end my intro with a quote from Dana Loesch. Dana says, quote, "The people who report your Twitter account and your Facebook pages because they dislike your opinion want you to trust a government-run system where people can, without serious penalty of law, report you and have your property confiscated before you're allowed to defend yourself in court weeks, even months later. Politicians refer to law-abiding gun-owning Americans as domestic security threats, yet want you to trust them with implementing such a system," unquote, Dana Loesch. Where would you like to begin with this, Ms. Lennox?
Well, first I would like to begin with this. Concealed carry weapons holders, appropriately licensed in their home states, have lower rates of crime than law enforcement officers, to include gun violence. Going after law-abiding legal gun owners does nothing. Straw purchases are one of the least prosecuted crimes in the states that actually have prohibitions, shall we say Illinois, specifically Chicago. They actually prosecuted and charged less people for holding illegal weapons than any other state in the union, despite their very strict laws. There is so much bad faith going around in this, to include the governor of my family's home state of New York, Andrew Cuomo, suggesting we should have a mental health registry. If you have a mental health registry, all that is going to do is discourage people from getting the care they need to keep their mental health in good order. I wouldn't get it if I was going to get put on a list. And the last thing I would like to say is this. The thing that nobody in the mainstream media is saying is when suicide rates in this country go up, so do mass shootings, because the most perpetrators of mass shootings intend to commit suicide by cop.
Did you see?
So,
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Given that we've had a 30% increase in suicides in this country since the year 2000, and it is now the second leading cause of death for children ages 10 to 34, we might want to take a look at what we're doing to our freaking culture, like telling kids the world's going to end in 12 years, like telling kids all their jobs are going to be automated away, because, yeah, the dummy in his manifesto decided to blame an outgroup for some of his problems, but if you read it, the dude literally thought he had no future. And until we can convince our kids there actually is a future that matters, the these problems are not going to go away.
Have you seen that the New York State Legislature has actually released radio ads in support of this mental health registry?
No, I have not, because I'm not in New York State. I left there for a reason, and that is the most disgusting thing ever.
I have a...
If you read Dr. Jean Twenge's book, she tells us with Gen Z, we are running into a mental health crisis. What would discourage anyone from getting mental health care is to believe they would be monitored by the freaking government. So if you want to solve mental health issues, that is exactly the wrong way to go.
We have a cut of the ads that are running on WABC Radio in New York. This is to support Governor Cuomo's mental health registry.
I hate this place. Nothing works here. The medications don't work. I've been here for 7 years.
He's going to have us all in the loony bin. But I want to circle back to a phrase I want to circle back to a phrase that you used in how you were breaking this all down. And this is what sums it up all to me. So you have to compartmentalize and put these red flag laws in baskets. So the first basket of issues you have are the constitutionality. When I was doing my notes for the show, right off the top of my head, it affects four of the first 10 amendments to the Bill of Rights. Yeah, what are those called? That's the Bill of Rights, Bob, the first 10 amendments. That's 40% of the Bill of Rights right away run into the do something. I want to feel good about myself. I want to feel good about myself, too, but I don't want to lose a constitutional republic because I'm doing this in over-emotive ways. So, again, let's take the emotion out of it. Let's get back to policy. Now, Stacey brought up a phrase that I thought was fantastic because it makes the point of all of this. And the word that she used was bad faith. If you are going to implement any kind of policy, law, amendment, what have you, that in any way, shape, or form is going to infringe upon the liberty of a constitutionally guaranteed right, then every member of this republic, of this society, has a right to believe that this would be done by actors, peoples, politicians, lawmakers, however you want to call it, in good faith. And what have we seen within the last week? We've seen a Democratic politician, Joaquin Castro, dox and send out the personal information of 44 donors to the Trump campaign. We have seen the left continually try to take people's public information, expose them, have them fired from their job, to deplatform them. You now have them talking about a mental health registry. No, I'm sure they won't weaponize that to keep guns out of the hands of people they don't like. You have two states in this union, the two largest states in this union, the state of New York and the state of California, both of which have passed bills of attainder.
Nah, what's a bill of attainder, JD?
Because, Bob, we live in a society that is supposed to guarantee equal protection under the law. Our Constitution prohibits the states from creating laws, the federal government as well, that are referred to as bills of attainder. And what bills of attainder are laws and legislations written to target or specifically affect one single individual. In the state of New York, you have the Assembly and the State Senate, signed by the governor, has done that in order to get the president's tax returns. And you have the state of California, through their Assembly, through their Senate, also signed by their governor, a law specifically to try and keep President Trump off the primary ballot by putting in requirements in the primary, which is extra and unconstitutional to begin with. So, if you're going to even entertain these laws, you need to do it in an environment where all the actors are acting in good faith. And these laws and the Republicans that are barreling to it are barreling towards it for two reasons. And none of them are to protect your constitutional rights or your individual liberty. They're barreling towards them because they are feckless eunuchs and cowards. They have the same exact political consultants who lost the 2018 midterms in the House for the Republicans, who lost the last two presidential cycles for the Republicans. All these geniuses are in these offices going, we're going to lose suburban women. We're going to lose suburban women because the suburban women want to feel like they did something. Well, you see, Congress wrote a law, none of which would have helped in either one of these two cases. But forget about that for a second. think about it in the terms of anybody who's even considering that these are a good idea. You are not dealing in an environment or with people who are dealing in good faith. These are people who want to destroy you. Our next segment after the commercial break is about how these people are trying to silence, erase, and destroy you. And you want to even contemplate giving them the ability to go to a magistrate, a sheriff, or what have you, however this shakes out. Marco Rubio can't, I mean, he can't wait to get these in place. And, you know, Stacey, we need to be rational in thinking about this, because the left is a motive. They have a solution for every tragedy. And people get tired of it, and they want the news cycle to pass. And they say, well, you know, if we do these laws, they'll stop banging the drum every day on cable television. And I just think that people on the right who are opening the door to this, I think are making a very, very big mistake.
Well, they're making a very, very big mistake because according to a Rand Corporation study, right, that looked at all of the studies for 13 different gun policies, the only thing that had a moderate impact on mass shootings or violent gun crime was, number one, background checks, which cover about 99% of gun sales at this point. And number two, stand your ground laws. What's a stand your ground law? That means if you come in my house, I can shoot your ass, and the state of Georgia isn't going to do anything to me because I have a castle. You're not allowed in it, right? So if people believe that the citizens may actually be armed, violent crime goes down.
Who knew?
And those are the only two circumstances that affect either one of those metrics in a way that actually matters.
Well, going back to the good faith discussion, I don't think that you can discuss this in a vacuum. Take a look at the last two sets of Democratic presidential debates. Take a look at what every one of these candidates is saying every day they get in front of a camera. I want to restrict this right. It's going to be a collective this and federal government that. That's the environment that we're in. You have an opposition party that is barreling towards fascistic control over everything in your life. And we got soccer moms and some people on the right going, we have to do something. What the red? Even the president. Even the president. And he's not a big 2A guy, folks. He's talked a lot about it, but trust me, JD is a lifelong, I lived in New York 40-something years before I came out here to the Southern California studios. Donald Trump is a fixture. I happen to like the man. I've loved him as president. But I'm going to tell you something. If you think that Donald Trump is Charlton Heston when it comes to gun rights, he's not.
No.
So usually the only guy at the top of the pyramid who's been fighting for us on the right has been the president. Because the House is a bunch of eunuchs. The Senate's a bunch of never-Trumpers. They might as well be Democrats. But in this particular case, folks, you have to make your voices known. You have, you know, people keep calling Rep. Dan Crenshaw a rock star on the right, which he had been. You have Crenshaw, a Texas rock rib conservative, making noise that we should do this. You have Rubio, who still has presidential ambitions, at some point down the road calling for this. You folks, you have to wake up. You have to wake up. Most of the time, people on our side aren't fighting for us. It's just the president. In this particular case, I'm not sure anybody is, because if you look at the people around him, you know, okay, this one's good on immigration. This one's good on policy. This one's good on taxes. I don't know a whole lot of, you know, outdoorsmen, Second Amendment types that are surrounding this president. So however you all have to make your voices heard, if you don't want to wake up one day and end up like Australia, New Zealand, or whatever other country, you know, has had these mandatory buybacks, which are basically a confiscation that's going to take us on the road to civil war, then wake up. Because this is not an issue you just want to use to let that news cycle spin away. You want to take this? Do you want to wrap this up for us before we go to break?
I mean, it's just literally when you look at the data, none of this do something crap is supported. Then letting people defend themselves the way they choose to defend themselves, because legal gun owners are, and especially concealed carry permits, are less likely to commit a crime of any kind, let alone a crime with a gun, than the entire population, to include law enforcement officers. Well, so you're going after the wrong people, and the only thing you do if you ban semi-automatic weapons is prevent me as a woman from defending my life because I am supposed to unload my gun into the core of a person. It becomes much harder without the semi-automatic functionality that actually serves a purpose, and they're being ridiculous.
Now, the way that J.D. protects himself is like Peter Sellers in that old Pink Panther movie. I actually take a little Asian man named Kato, and I stick him in the closet, and I come home, and he goes, "Wah!" Coming back on the other side. White supremacy means you just have to shut up. J.D. and Stacey are going to pay some bills live. Game on KLRN Radio.
My son was in the Army back during Desert Storm, but even then, he wanted an MBA. He looked at a dozen schools, but only one offered the online education and flexibility he needed while he was in a tent in Iraq, Grantham University. Turns out that Grantham's been delivering affordable, relevant college and advanced degrees for over 65 years. Heck, if they can deliver a quality education to a soldier in a tent overseas, think about the flexibility Grantham can offer you so you can earn your degree too. It doesn't matter how complicated or full your life is, if getting a degree is on your bucket list, you'll want to do what my son did. You'll want to call Grantham. Find out how easy it is to get started on your education so you can check that college degree off your bucket list. Call Grantham right now. 800-910-1370. That's 800-910-1370. Flexible, affordable, relevant. Call 800-910-1370.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Attention business owners and independent contractors. This is a money-saving message from Tax Mediation Services. If your business owes $20,000 or more in taxes, we can help you today, right now. Listen, dealing with the IRS is no picnic. It's an intimidating and extremely stressful process, and you don't want to go it alone. Our attorneys know every law, every tax break, and every possible opportunity to help you resolve and reduce your tax debt. And if you owe more than $20,000, you may be at the top of their hit list. So don't take your tax debt lightly because it will not go away on its own. The IRS can seize your bank accounts, your home, and even shut down your business. Call our tax experts today at 1-800-783-0810 and let us deal with the IRS while you focus on your business. That's 1-800-783-0810. Again, that's 800-783-0810.
Welcome back, JD and Stacy here, live hosting Game On tonight, KLRN Radio. Welcome back to all our political freaks, geeks, back alley sneaks. Get in that chat room, say hello to Stacy, join the conversation. Ron refuses to wear any kind of pants, so 18 to 80, blind, crippled, and crazy. Lock those kids up, get next to that radio, listen to the show with your baby. We want to thank everybody for joining us live here every Sunday evening, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5 p.m. Pacific, on Game On, the fastest growing political radio show in the country, and that's all because of you. We can't thank you enough. So many places for you to go to enjoy your entertainment on a Sunday evening. The fact that you spend it with us makes us eternally happy. For those of you who just listen to the show and are not in the chat room, you get over to Spreaker.com, get on JD and Stacey's page, you get in that chat room, you say hello to everybody. There's a party going on there. Cocaine on the tables, dancing girls, the whole nine. Wah, wah, wah. Welcome back.
Hey,
Yeah! How's the dancing room party going on in the chat room?
The chat room's going well.
Yeah. This is what
they mostly agree with us. I know that's shocking.
This is what I like about this show. So I don't just have to listen. I go in the chat room. I say hello to the people. You know, if you were on Saturday, I could not listen to the show.
You're schwitzing like a moil?
I am schwitzing like a moil. In the Southern California... Let me tell you something, girl chick. In the Southern California studios, right? Because we love the people so much, we say to the people, we say, we don't want to, give you the bad show. So we shut off the air conditioning so it you don't get the hum, the noise they make from the air conditioner. So it for you is nice, but for me is schwitzing like a moil. I was an old Jew, I was a Russian, I don't know what happened.
Somebody's saying moles don't schwitz. We said moil.
Moil. Moles. Ah, what are you, Hans?
Schwitzing like a moil.
Hans Molman. Good Lord. Oh, man. We did that segment. We got the other one coming up here. I think Archie Bunker's got it right. Tell him, Archie. Tell him.
The country is going straight into the dumper.
Schwitzing like a moil. Yeah, listen, you grow up in New York. By the time you're five, I don't care what your nationality is, you know a few ghetto Yiddish words to bring
even
up.
Even I know a few, and I was upstate. Speaking of upstate, so glad my Giants beat the Jets, even in preseason.
Okay, you listen, lady. It was preseason.
Here come all the excuses.
It's not excuses. Listen, just because you're a woman and don't understand sports and make yourself look like a hoople on national radio, I can't help you. This is preseason.
You can't help me.
It works completely. Mm-hmm. It works completely mm-hmm. different. There's a series or two. Let's wait till they face themselves in the... let me tell you something. I will guarantee you right now on air that Sam Darnold starts more games next season than Eli Manning.
Oh, because, I would totally agree with that. Eli's an old man.
Because your team is an absolute hot mess. They're in a big transition. And
you're telling me this?
And you know who's
after the last 5 years of the Jets?
I'm sorry. Uh-huh. I'm sorry. I couldn't hear you.
Remember that one season when, like, we had to find out what your quarterback was doing, like, the next Sunday for golf because they blew it in the playoffs? Yeah, I remember that, too.
Folks, I think just this sums up my co-host and just about everybody else.
Is it my imagination, or does every woman in New York have a severe emotional problem?
They have severe emotional problems.
I'm not in New York.
Okay, so well, whatever. It makes the point. So where? Oh, you want to know what? Where is? I think we got the perfect. I got the perfect theme to start off our next segment.
Oh, God.
And for those of you who have not been paying attention, let me just tell you, wake up, white people. Because while you were just being white and taking care of your family and believing in Jesus and the Constitution, the Democratic Party done woke up and decided we's all what they call them white supremacists. And I don't know about y'all, but I don't feel like I'm a white supremacist. Stacey, is you a white supremacist?
No, and, you know, when did we run into each other on social media? Like, around 2014?
In 2012. It was after the first debate in that election.
2012, 2013. Okay, yeah. I've been being told I was a racist and a white supremacist since I opposed Obamacare. These people have so overused this word, they called Mitt Romney the most anodyne freaking milquetoast dude in the entire world. Joe Biden went in public at a meeting of African-American leaders and said he wants to put y'all back in chains. They have literally been doing this to every Republican in my lifetime since Reagan. My understanding of the history, it's actually since Goldwater.
I'll tell you what, I'll double down on it. You think I'm a white supremacist? Have some of this.
Hey, where are the white women at? You know, folks, this has always been the left's tactic, but what you're seeing right now in the Democratic Party and with these Democratic candidates, it's where that they've been for the last 20 years, and they want to. This is where they've wanted to be all along, and they're finally here. You have to understand what Obama brought into the forefront for the left, for the progressive movement, for the radical base. He brought in community organizing, and there was a lot of talk about Saul Alinsky and Alinskyite tactics. And that's exactly what's being done in this particular case. What they've done is they've found an issue. That would be us, Republican voters. They've isolated it. That would be this moment in time with the claims of racism and white supremacy. And they've personalized it. Because when you call people who disagree with you a white supremacist, it is a dog whistle to everybody else that that person is to be shunned. That person is to be deplatformed. That person is not to be spoken to. This is nothing more than a Stalinist tactic to get you to shut up, to get people to not say they support this president. And I would like everybody in the audience, if they can, to do one thing for JD. And if you never do anything else, please do this. Please stop starting every conversation that you have with somebody on the left by going, well, of course I'm not a white supremacist, or of course I don't believe in white supremacy, because you're playing into their hands. Nobody thinks that you, nobody in good faith thinks that you are. What they want you to do is begin every conversation and policy argument on your back foot. So basically it's racial AA. Hi, I'm JD, and I'm a white guy. It's been 6 months and 11 days since I realized that I had white privilege. Go chase yourself, white privilege. This is all this is. And if you don't think that this is a Stalinist tactic, and if you don't believe, and this goes back to the red flag law conversation, the progressives and the left in this country, they move everything by inches. I was surprised to hear about what I'm about to tell you. Bear with me for a second, folks. I found this very interesting. The front runner, if you put their polling together, Liz Warren and Bernie Sanders are polling at or above Joe Biden right now. So the heart of the Democratic primary voter base is very much with the quote-unquote progressives. Now, the isolating of this speech to call everybody a white supremacist, whether it's true or not, is actually straight out of Stalin's NKVD secret police disinformation playbook. And I found this article I'm going to quote from here. And it says, this clandestine approach to, or should we say sabotage of, the foundations of American life and politics didn't begin with Trump. It began long ago, even before the Roosevelt years, and has ebbed and flowed since. This recent rise can be dated from 1991. Keep in mind, folks, right before the fall of the former Soviet Union, when then Vermont Congressman, now presidential candidate, Bernie Sanders, helped found the Congressional Progressive Caucus along with Rep. Maxine Waters and a few others. Sanders at that point was just back when they founded the Progressive Caucus from his honeymoon in the Soviet Union. Do you know who the fourth inaugural member of the Progressive Caucus was in 1991? Jerry Nadler.
Oh, really? Ew.
What most people also don't know is that Jerry Nadler, if not now, was an avowed socialist for quite some time. He was a member of several socialist organizations and was the one who convinced President Bill Clinton to commute, during his last days in office, Susan Rosenberg's sentence.
How is Susan Rosenberg, J.D.?
In 1981, Susan Rosenberg drove a getaway car for the left-wing terror group, the Weather Underground, and the Black Liberation Army, after they had robbed a Brinks truck, killing two policemen and a security guard in the process. Folks, Black Lives Matter, pigs in a blanket, fry them like bacon, Colin Kaepernick, cops are evil, white supremacy. This isn't something that they just pulled out of thin air. This has been a slow, creeping progression of isolating, personalizing, and demonizing anybody who does not believe in the agenda that they are trying to sell. So let's bring this back to white supremacy and white nationalism, whatever the hell that is. All that is right now is the next step from these same people who since 1991, after returning from a communist regime and establishing a progressive caucus based on what they had learned from that communist regime, we're now about 30 years into the implementation of this. About 30 years deep into the implementation of this. So, Stacey, this is not, this white supremacy nonsense is just another play in a very old and deep playbook.
It actually went back longer than that, like to the 30s, back to the Fabian. I mean, there's articles in Forbes calling President Barack Obama the first Fabian socialist because he was taking over healthcare first. If you look, they're still trying to do that even more than Obamacare allowed them to. It was talking about slow marches through the institutions. So as you see everything going on college campuses and the shut-uppery there and the assault on young men who are being kicked out of college, right, for specious allegations, this is all what the Fabians envisioned years ago.
But back to what they envision, back to what they're doing now. We are the only ones that can prevent this from being a successful strategy. Uh-huh. Look, we have been mollified into, whether it's saltpeter in the water, fluoride, whatever you want to call it, we have been mollified through political correctness, whatever you want to say. Look, there is already a large, large restriction on the First Amendment, and we all self-limit ourselves.
Well, you know that the illegal immigrants can't—they commit crimes less than a native-born. Well, actually, no. If you look at the federal, shut up, racist. Oh, yeah, I don't want anybody to think I'm a racist. You know the Black Lives Matter. This is just a manifestation of suppression of systematic with suppression. Well, no, maybe it was. Hey, what are you, a racist? Shut up. Yeah, I don't want to be a racist. This has got to stop. This has got to stop. There are no more racist people on the face of the planet than the left and the progressives. Because they do not believe that people of color cannot think outside the boxes that they have checked for them. And then when they do, they demonize them like, what, they're running around calling Candace Owens a white supremacist. So stop.
And Ben Shapiro.
So stop.
And Larry Elder.
And Ben Shapiro. I mean, this is the brain trust that you're dealing with. This is the brain trust that you're dealing with. They are running around and calling blacks and Jews white supremacists. White supremacists. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, look, I'm all up for a good moronic joke, but this is ridiculous. This is you know who's a big white supremacist? Who? Ben Shapiro. He's an Orthodox Jew. Ah, yeah, well, don't you know that?
He literally has 24/7 security because the actual white supremacists hate him.
But this is my whole point, Stacey. If we don't fight back against this, if we don't start refusing to play from this perspective, this dynamic, and I'm not a white supremacist, but no, neither do I. But I've seen people in the audience do it. I want them to feel free. Stop with this. There is nothing wrong with being a white people. Just like there's nothing wrong with being a black people.
I feel absolutely no obligation to denounce an ideology I have never agreed with, nor do I exhibit any symptoms of. And literally, I was over this in 2008 when I was accused of being a racist for not agreeing with healthcare policy. That's not how any of this works. I don't agree with Bernie Sanders. I don't agree with Elizabeth Warren. I don't agree with Nancy Pelosi. So really, just stop.
How can you not? Were you telling me that you do not agree with me? I wrote the damn bill. I wrote the bill saying that it blows. No.
It does, Bernie.
No, that was Kamala Harris. You can ask Mayor Willie Brown. But that's not what we are talking. We are talking about the fact that,
and it just, you know, this whole idiocy. Yeah, Pope Pete, Mayor Midget, Mr. Morality. And I'm going to tell you something. I don't care how this sounds because I absolutely believe this. I have never seen, whether it's the media or the left, agitate so consistently and vociferously to stir up a race war in this country. And it's only because the president has increased support with black supporters. Understand who you're dealing with, folks. This is nothing about raw political power and the attempt to gain it and never lose it till the end of time and we're all in FEMA camps. Take us to break, lady. What do you got?
I ain't going to a FEMA camp.
Yeah. Are you going to take it to a break?
Like, I know that you're very impassioned on this. Literally, I've been hearing it for 11 years now. Like, at some point, it just rolls off your back. You have no proof that that's how I live, and you don't know me. Legit, that's what people need to start to take it as. These people have no right to assume your motives. They have no right to assume your perspective. And they have no right over a policy discussion to say that it reflects on how you view people who have a different skin color than you, because that's crap. And that's how they're going to lose every single argument. They can't argue their policies anymore because they stink.
The last time something rolled down JD's back, it was 4:30 in the morning in a Las Vegas hotel room, and it cost me $50 extra. Coming back on the other side of the break, we're going to take 3.5 minutes, pay some bills, nonsense of the world, and so much more. JD and Stacey live hosting a game on that KLRN radio. We'll be right back.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Attention business owners and independent contractors. This is a money-saving message from Tax Mediation Services. If your business owes $20,000 or more in taxes, we can help you today, right now. Listen, dealing with the IRS is no picnic. It's an intimidating and extremely stressful process, and you don't want to go it alone. Our attorneys know every law, every tax break, and every possible opportunity to help you resolve and reduce your tax debt. And if you owe more than $20,000, you may be at the top of their hit list. So don't take your tax debt lightly, because it will not go away on its own. The IRS can seize your bank accounts, your home, and even shut down your business. Call our tax experts today at 1-800-783-0810 and let us deal with the IRS while you focus on your business. That's 1-800-783-0810. Again, that's 800-783-0810.
Whether we realize it or not, everyone has been impacted by addiction. We all have family members, we all have friends that have faced this demon. But there's hope. There's hope in recovery. There's hope when we work together to rise above the plight of addiction. I'd like you to join Mac Mullings every Saturday from 2 to 4 p.m. on Rise Above Radio on KOKC 1520 AM, where they talk about the hope that is available to all of us.
Waddle-doodle. Welcome back to It's Okay to Be White People Radio. JD and Stacy here live hosting Game On, closing out to the top of that 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Hour here live on that KLRN radio. We want to thank everybody in the audience, everybody who catches us on the replay during the week. We want to thank iHeart. We want to thank Spotify. We want to thank that KLRN radio, that Ricky Ticky Tavi Rick Robinson, that KLRN radio family, and especially you find us here live every Sunday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 5 p.m. Pacific for those of us out here in the California studio. So thank you, and welcome back, baby.
Hey, how we doing?
Oh, you know, I got an itch. You know what it was? I was making notes during the break. It was that the last commercial break. I was glad I was, you know, sometimes I'll check out and do something else, but I'm glad I had it on. I made a note. I was making notes. The last commercial segment reminded me I have to quit doing cocaine. I need to pay my back taxes and fix the issues with my schmeckle.
I don't even want to know about number three.
Well, I paid the wrong tax on my schmeckle.
I didn't even know there was a tax on that.
I'm in California. There's a tax on everything. What are you? How did the second American Revolution start? Well, we were living through 90% confiscatory tax rates and a completely open border, but when they passed the Schmeckle tax, that was the end.
That would be the end.
Hey, where are the white women at?
Exactly.
So what are we doing for nonsense? Are we just covering Biden, or are we going through these articles?
Well.
Gee, your hair smells terrific.
That would be Biden.
Let's do some of I didn't even want to. It wasn't planned. Somebody needs to. Joe Biden is quickly becoming the old person in the home who has the gown on backwards and is just walking down the hall at like 3 p.m. giving everyone a show.
It's literally down to one of two things at this point. He either just lies, and I mean lies, or he's got a little bit of dementia.
It's
one or the other. There is no midpoint.
I think it's great. He was out there the other day, and he's like, yes, and I have to tell you something, that poor children are just as capable of white children. And an entire audience of Democrats was like,
Are we allowed to scream racist at that?
No.
Can't we look at Joe Biden and say, you old racist, you collaborated with white supremacists who were all Democrats, you racist. Get him out.
Ladies,
I want Trump to run against Elizabeth Warren. That's what I want.
Ladies and gentlemen, JD and Stacey's prediction and ode to the Biden campaign.
Grand opening, grand closing.
That was JD's prediction.
Grand opening, grand closing.
I don't listen. How much longer can you
I've been in complete agreement with Ben Shapiro for months. His first day was going to be his best day. But when he came out today and lied, 100% lie. I met with the Parkland students while I was VP.
Listen, I love the senility, though, because he's like, that's right. I was for busing. And I'm still for busing. Really? Could you expand on that a little bit? I absolutely believe that black people should still ride in the back of the bus. No, Joe, there's a
Joe,
50
Joe,
years,
you're
Joe.
You're not
no.
supposed to say Wait, the quiet what? Part oh, out
no,
loud.
No, sorry.
Oh, my God, that quote about poor kids versus white kids, I like literally cringed when I read it.
Mr. Former Vice President, would you like to clarify your position?
What he said about Obama?
Would you like to clarify your position on busing? Oh, yeah. Well, how else are you going to get the Cullens to the jail?
Okay, terrific.
Does
nobody remember what he said about Barack Obama?
It was
Does nobody
so
remember
clean?
What he
oh,
said
clean.
About gas station owners of Indian descent. Does nobody remember this stuff? This is Joe Biden.
Oh, the best is when he was doing that thing and he's like, oh, your mom used to live on Long Island. God rest her soul. Oh, mom's here. God bless her soul. It's your dad who died. It's just too much. Okay, less than 2 minutes. What did we have?
Oh, we have Joe Scarborough.
What was the... Oh, yeah.
Joe Scarborough and Joy Ann Reid both decided that the death of Jeffrey Epstein was a Trump-Russia conspiracy.
Bah, he's very... You know, it was Putin who said, we must get the dumb white man and the black woman who hates the gays. And
I want to know if they ever found the hacker that put all the homophobic comments on her website.
Yeah, the hacker's name was Moy Bede.
Oh, my God. But no, she's literally on MSNBC articulating that she is sure Epstein's death was a plot managed by our Attorney General, William Barr.
She ain't articulating nothing. What's next? One more, I think. What do we got?
What is the sources? AB says no football without old helmet. I don't know about the helmet controversy.
Oh, for those of you. Sports fans out there will know what I'm talking about. I know we have enough time to get into it. JD's prediction, Antonio Brown is heading light speed into becoming the next Terrell Owens. But this is the point in the show when I look at my beautiful and brilliant co-host and I go, baby, you got them keys?
I got those keys.
Why don't you tell the nice people who you is, what you do, and where they can find you?
I am at Scott's Fire on almost every social media platform. You can probably start finding me on Clout Hub when Twitter suspends me for making fun of the tranny who wanted their nuts waxed in Canada. But anyway, I also write for The Resurgent and
I'm all with the tranny nutcracking. JD, our bulletproof vest, boss duels, alleyways, donkey shows. If I live through it, I'll see you next week.
I'm looking for you, you Occupy freaks, with your glitter bombs. Bring it on! Bring on the glitter. Everything has changed in the last few years. Conservatives used to take it, and we're not taking it anymore.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
Everyone loves liberty. Our rights come from God, not the government. So why are you letting other people tell you what's best for your health care? Exercise your freedom with Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare is a community of people who voluntarily share one another's medical costs. Liberty HealthShare is founded on the idea that most people truly want to help one another. Healthcare sharing allows members to do just that as a true community that supports one another in times of need. Liberty believes people should make decisions for themselves and their families. Members are able to take back the freedom to make their own decisions about their health care. Freedom from guilt or doubt about how your money is used. You have the freedom to direct your health care, not to be dictated to by bureaucrats. Stop letting others tell you what to do and join a community of like-minded people. Exercise your freedom. Join Liberty HealthShare and take back the control of your health care while helping those around you. Call Liberty at 855-58-LIBERTY. Again, that's 855-58-LIBERTY for more information, or you can check them out at libertyhealthshare.org. Again, that's libertyhealthshare.org.
Here's George Foreman with InventHelp.
Hi, I'm George Foreman. Do you have an idea for a new product or invention? People ask me all the time, George, how do I get my idea in front of companies? How do I get a patent? What do I do next? Do you have the same questions? I'll tell you like I'll tell them all. Call my friends at InventHelp.
Call InventHelp today for free information. InventHelp has been helping inventors for more than 30 years and has sales offices nationwide. InventHelp can submit your invention to companies who are interested in receiving new you ideas. If you have an idea and want to try to patent it and submit it to companies, you should call InventHelp today for free information.
Listen, I can't guarantee your company will be interested in your idea, but I believe every inventor deserves the opportunity to step into the ring and take their best shot. Put InventHelp in your corner.
Get your free inventor's information. Call 1-800-353-6490. That's 1-800-353-6490. Again, 1-800-353-6490.
At St. Jude, a family never sees a bill at all. It's like the world has been lifted off of your shoulders.
St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. Finding cures, saving children. Learn more at stjude.org.